may not realize the health of California's aquatic life is affected by the type of brakes on your car.
Everywhere there are cars, there are copper particles being left behind by their brakes.
During storm season, dust from brake pads washes off roadways, down storm drains, and into California's rivers, streams, and marine waters. In 2010, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency estimated 1.3 million pounds of copper from brake pads made its way into California's waterways and environment. That's equivalent to the weight of 325 cars.
The science that helped us understand this problem came from a collaboration between stormwater agencies, environmental groups, and manufacturers.
The Brake Pad Partnership studied the effects of copper from brakes in San Francisco Bay Area watersheds.
That study found that copper from brake pads was the single highest contributor to elevated copper levels in urban creeks.
Highway stormwater runoff is toxic to fish such as salmon and trout. Fish use their sense of smell to navigate waterways and avoid predators. Exposure to copper can disrupt fish's ability to smell, which makes it difficult for them to find their way back home to breed and leaves them defenseless against predators.
It's toxic to shellfish as well as fish. So, you know, we're talking about an effect that is potentially far-reaching and over time can really have some adverse impacts.
Fly fisherman and DTSC research scientist Robert Brucia says restricting copper and heavy metals in brake pads is a good thing for fish and the environment.
Over time, the more that we can do to stop dumping pollutants or toxins into our waterways, ultimately the better it's going to be for the resource.
In 2010, California passed SB 346. The Department of Toxic Substances Control is working on the regulations.
These regulations in support of SB 346 set levels for copper, asbestos, cadmium, and other metals in brake pads.
The law also emphasizes that by 2021, brake pads sold in California must contain no more than 5% copper. And by 2025, the law reduces the amount of copper in brakes to less than 1%. California isn't the first state working to put the brakes on highway runoff pollution. Washington State and California worked together to create standards for these regulations. In 2015, Washington State's brake pad regulations went into effect. Around the same time, an agreement was reached between the US EPA, the Environmental Council of States, and the auto industry to address copper in brake pads. It's estimated California will save $1 billion in stormwater treatment costs once the law goes into full effect.
40% of the products on the market today meet the requirements set by these regulations for the year 2025.
The US EPA believes Washington State and California's new brake pad laws will lead to nationwide compliance by auto manufacturers, shops, and auto part retailers, and in turn, help reduce pollution in waterways throughout the nation.